Hello, this is Cynthia Sue Larson with realityshifters.com, and today I'm here talking about biocentrism and the idea of what if life selected this universe. The idea comes from a book that was written by Robert Lanza and co-authored with Bob Berman. The subtitle of the book, Biocentrism, says how life and consciousness are the keys to understanding the true nature of the universe. And while this is an extraordinary concept, I don't think it's that far-fetched, because what the authors are talking about is the idea of fine-tuning and what you might think of as the Goldilocks effect. But before I get to that, let me just ask you to think about the way your daily life tends to unfold. And if you think about folding, you might think of laundry, you might think of how things get to be a mess pretty fast if you don't take time to take care of them. In other words, you need to clean things up. You need to work against what seems to be this chaotic nature, sort of a thing that we take for granted in our natural world, in just all everywhere around us. We tend to assume that if you leave things to their own devices, they fall apart. That's, however, runs completely counter to what we learn to be true of the universe that we live in. When you think about the unlikelihood of this universe being the way it is, with our planet exactly the right distance from our sun to be the best position for life, when you think about the fine, all of the gravitational constants, all of the cosmological constants, just everything that is the way it is, so that we have a planet that supports not just our life, but the vast, wonderful, interconnected network of plants and animals on this planet that we find. So getting back to the premise of this book, Biocentrism, the authors suggest that much of the reason for everything being as perfect as we witness it is that actually life itself has done the selecting. And you might wonder, how is that possible? In fact, that's one thing that I wonder myself. If at some points in the history of this amazing, what looks like a multiverse of possibilities is out there, then how is it that life can go all the way back in time to get things set up exactly right for itself? And while the authors don't give all of the nuts and bolts of exactly how that would work in terms of an exact paradigm or a model, they do suggest that there is an amazing interconnectedness between what we now know to be true from the quantum realm and the connections that we also know now to be true to the macroscopic realm. This I fully support. So I strongly encourage you to check this book out, take a look at it, and if you're also interested in further reading about my thoughts on the multiverse, specifically how we navigate our own lives according to the same similar kind of a concept, just on a daily basis, things you can do to test this theory out, and quantum jump starts that you can get going on right away. My book, Quantum Jumps, An Extraordinary Science of Happiness and Prosperity, provides all that. So these are two books that really are extremely thought-provoking. And the biocentrism one, of course, is controversial as well, because some people are contesting the fact that all of life has such a big say, and others feel strongly that selecting life according to our own concept of what that is very limited. I say put those concerns aside, evaluate the book based on its merits, biocentrism, that is, check it out, and for sure it's going to expand your mind and give you a lot more to think about when you ask my favorite question, how good can it get? Until next time, this is Cynthia Sue Larson with realityshifters.com.